Knowledge has the beginning but no end. Good morning to all of you. I am Dr. I. Manimali, IEEE Branch Counselor in the East Point College of Engineering. It gives me a great pleasure to welcome all the distinguished experts gathered in the wonderful morning. I would like to invite Professor Navya Ma'am to play a digital song for inaugurations.
Sure, Ma'am. Thank you, Ma'am.
I would like to remember in the pleasant occasions our beloved founder chairman, Dr. S. M. Venkatpathi ji, East Point Group of Institutions. I would like to welcome our respectable chairperson, P.L. Ramadevi ma'am, East Point Group of Institutions. In her absence, yeah, welcome ma'am. My hearty welcome to our CEOs, Sri Pramod Gowda sir and Sri Raji Gowda sir, East Point Group of Institutions. Welcome sir, in his absence, yeah. I would like to welcome our secretary, Peter Francis, East Point Group of Institutions. Welcome you, sir, in his absence here. This platform is an opportunity to welcome our chief guest of the today functions, Mr. Paramananda Jana, scientist of LRDE DRDO Bangalore. I would like to welcome our beloved principal, Dr. Prakash S, in his absence here, eminent CSE HOD, Dr. T.K. Satish, Resourceful Head, Dr. Yogesh D.S., Department of ECE, IQAC Head, Dr. Shiva Sir, Professor Kemparaj Sir, Department of ISE, Dr. Nagaraj Sitaram Sir, Department of Civil, Dr. Harish Anand Sir, Department of Mechanical, Dr. Maruti Sir, Basic Science Department, Dr. Shukla Sir, and Dr. Dureswamy Sir, and a very active placement officer, Dr. Dhananjayan Sir, and all the faculty members and all the students. Welcome all of you. I'm extremely overwhelmed to get this opportunity to address three legends of this auspicious occasions. A true leader has the confidence, stand alone, the courage to make tough decisions, and the competence to listen to others' needs. Leaders become a great not because of their powers, because of their ability to create more leaders. None other than Dr. Prakash S. I welcome you, sir. If your vision and action inspire others to dream more, to learn more, and do more, and become a more. None other than, I would like to welcome our Dr. T.K. Satish, IEEE TEMS Student Branch Advisor, East Point Group of Institutions. The leader is the one who knows the way, goes the way, shows the way, think the way, communicate the way, and success the way. each and every success is a behind of the East Point Group of Institutions. None other than I would like to welcome Dr. Yogesh G.S., IEEE Student Branch Chapter Advisor, East Point Group of Institutions. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Now, I would like to call our CSE HOD talk about a few words about this event.
Good morning to all, and thank you very much, Dr. Mali Mohan ji and Dr. Jena sir and Dr. Yogesh sir and all the other participants who are here. In any particular this, you know, the miniature antennas, essentially we need to be able to see that how do we essentially consume less and less physical space. So that has been the major particular focus in any electronics particular this. So in that particular sense, you know, I mean, it's because of the civil applications also there rather than just military applications. And if you look at the normal, the 5G and the 6G that is coming along the way, I think, you know, these areas are going to be of more interest. Whereas initially it used to be more of an interest for the business or the R&D houses. Now this can be of more uses in the civilian area. So in this particular area, we do have a great expert with us. Sir, thank you very much for your time. It will be a pleasure for us, and we would rather make use of this opportunity to listen to you and to learn from you and to see that how essentially the students can get into this particular branch of the area, and they can do some small projects and essentially help themselves to contribute to this area. So with these few words, and I would thank you all once again, and have a wonderful session.
Thank you, sir. Now I'd like to request our resourceful head, Dr. Yogesh G.S., to talk about few words.
Very good morning, everyone. It's a great pleasure and honor to speak on this occasion. See, sensor is a part of our every human being, whether it's a domestic application or any other applications. For example, if you take example of gas sensing, if there is a gas leakage, sensors plays a very important role for saving of life. When it comes to military applications, definitely sensor plays a very major role, and it's very sensitive matter also. So in this regard, we thought let us have a eminent personality like sir, so that he can give elaborate session on emerging sensor technologies of millimeter wave radar for civil and military applications. I think it's the right occasion for all of us to listen to him. I heartfully welcome once again our chief guest for the day and all other dignitaries. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. It's very honored to introduce such a potential person from LRDE DRDO. I would like to introduce Paramananda Jana, has obtained the BE degree in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering from Veer Surendra Sai University at Odisha in the year of 1998, and MA degree in Microelectronics System from IIC Bangalore in the year of 2005. Currently, he is a scientist chief in the Electronics Radar Development Establishment, LRDE DRDO Bangalore. His area of interest are radar signal processing, waveform design, multiple input and multiple output radar, frequency modulated continuous wave radar. He has successfully designed field programmable gate arrays based on the signal processor for portable radars. He was a project director for the Hostile Server Lines to protect the Indian host line. Currently, he is leading the team of development of the radar for active protection system to protect the main battle tank and Indian Army, and the navigation radar for submarine for Indian Navy. He is a recipient of Agni Awards for the self-reliance for the development of portable radars, namely battlefield surveillance radar, low-level lightweight radars in the year of 2003, 2010, and 2011 repeatedly. He has also received the Laboratory Scientist of the Year of the development of the field programmable gate array based on the signal processor. Technology is a main successful development of postal surveillance radar. Thank you, sir. It's over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, all of you. Actually, that my introduction and inviting me to give opportunity to address the students and as a scientist, what we do to share with you, and I'll try my best. And thank you very much, actually. But I hope that I'll rise to the occasion to meet the demands of your institute. Let us try, actually. I'll just I'll share my presentations.
Sure, sir.
So good morning to everybody. So this talk is basically emerging sensor technologies of MMWave radar for civil and military applications. So my talk include but not limited to the following. So what I'll do, I'll give you in fact in three parts. So my initial will be introduction to radar technology, followed by I'll focus more on this millimeter wave radar. And this 1 millimeter radar, what I have worked for signal processor development, and we have delivered to one of our lab. Then I'll focus more on the contemporary military application of millimeter radars. That will be part two. And the part three, I think more relevant to all of you, that is basically I'm currently working. That is basically millimeter radar for automotive applications, which, and it will also that I have some research interest, and I'm currently doing research on medical and certain literature survey I carried out on this as a sensor networks. Radar is a potential sensor for IoT, and some of the research what 5G and 6G, and the coexistence of radar and telecommunications, and some sort of research area. So this is basically the radar. What it does, it is nothing but a electromagnetic sensors which transmit the electromagnetic waves, and primarily most of the popular radars are pulse radars. So the radar transmits the electromagnetic pulse, and the electromagnetic pulse propagates and hit the target as shown in the figure, and try to get the echo, and the echo travels at the distance of R, and the signal from antenna to target detection device. So the total distance covered by the wave is around 2 R. And we measure the delay, and the delay is directly proportional to the range. So the finally the R is measured. That is the names radar comes: radio detection and ranging. So it not only this is only a rudimentary way radar measure the range, but now radar not only measure the range, it measure the velocity, is measure the so many other things, and angle, elevations, Doppler. Subsequently, I'll talk about that. But the basic the history of the radar starts with using a radio waves to detect a target remotely, which was a big challenge before World War II. So this is basically the signal comes, but nowadays due to so digitizations, you can have to the echo has to be digitized, is the name we call video, and this data has been analyzed. You have to find the range, and similar to communications, we do the quadrature demodulations of the signal, and the subsequent the complex digital numbers are processed called signal processes, and the signal processor actually does signal processing to extract the range informations, Doppler informations, angle, and any other extra parameters. So my presentations will tell you that the way we perceive about the radar, and the way the research and modern technology and the other VLSI development has influencing the radar, and the very different non-conventional application radar as well. So this is the basically the classical way for military application. Primarily radars are used for search application, basically early warning. Mostly you might have seen in AWACS, the early warning radars, those are used for military. And radars are used local the motors, basically artillery fires from the enemy fires, and sometimes radar used to correct the fire also. And there is a civilian applications what we have seen in all the airports, the air traffic control radar, which is the one of the primary civilian offshoot of radar. And navigations, what you might have seen, most of the aircraft will have altimeters, is nothing but APS radar, which always try to guide the aircraft to maintain the to follow the terrain, so avoid the terrain obstacles, etc. another thing called tracking. This is basically tracking a muse for military, that's called fire control. Like before, particularly hostile aircraft has to be tracked before to engage in missiles. And there are different varieties of tracking radars are used in the military. Another invention, what even in the terms of not only for radar, it is a technology called synthetic aperture radar, which is a very one of the greatest advance or greatest discovery in a radar technology, which has been popular from 1960 onwards. So you can see all these remote sensing satellites for this space explorations, for our weather forecasting, all the things synthetic aperture are used, and the platform like UAV aircraft, or it will be ported on a satellite or space vehicles. Intercept attack radar, these are very quick reactions, fire control radars. Guide radars are used to guide. Sometimes not only they will track the target, they will guide the missile to engage it very accurately. Since the development of signal processing and all these artificial classification technologies, now radars are able to identify the targets. This measure, basically radar does a measuring operation that you might have seen, the velocity meter radar, particularly used by the police when you travel in the roads. So when you move very fast, that is also a radar, that is a continuous wave radar. Running radar, that is basically for radars, particularly military radars used for rendezvous or the locking of the space vehicles. Then very specific kind of radars are used for micro landing systems, for particularly in airports. So what radar measures? Radar measures the range of the targets and the velocity, azimuth, the altitude, the height of the targets. And radars are now being used basically due to sophisticated signal processing. Radar can measure the acceleration of the targets, the size, shape, sometimes the electromagnetic fingerprinting. The radar can do a fingerprinting of the target by using advanced electromagnetic features or other features which is captured by the electromagnetic signals. But you can see that these are things like, since we belong to the community of electronics engineering, the spectrums are being exploited from the time immemorial, means like from the advent of electromagnetic radiation by Maxwell and Hertz. So people started working with very low high frequency, that around 220 megahertz, 30 megahertz. Initial radars also high frequency radars. People see the radars, those are used in World War II. They are basically 30 megahertz Chenum radar by British, who was able to intercept the German aircraft, and that was the fate of the World War, we decided. So radar plays a role, and radar became popular by the successful use of the radar first time in the which is the World War. And that way, a lot of academics, particularly in the West, they took interest, and they continued to research not only for signal processing, the components, other things. Then parallelly, there is a lot of technologies happen in communication, particularly VHA and other things. So that getting directly adapted by radar. So we have a lot of radars till now also operationals, particularly Russian radars for long-range anti-circular VHFs, and now currently again due to signal processing, people are going for VHF as well. And UHF radars are also, it is a transition. So when you go up in the frequency, your size of the radar goes down, and the making the antennas and other things we can measure. So a lot of radars till now also operational, particularly in Russia, is UHF radars. And there's a main thing that happened, that is the advent of the magnetron in World War II. So that is basically, suddenly there is a need of reduce the radar size. If you see the radar in HA, VHA, VHF, they're huge. It is like a multi-story buildings or like a telephone towers. Then suddenly there is invention of a magnetron by Birmingham University in UK, and with the help of Naval Research Laboratory of USA combined, there is a duplexer was designed by Nanal. They made the L-band radar. So the entire wartime, 4 or 5 years, a micro radar came to force. That was the edge of allies to defeated the Axis power. Then actually, the parallel with the communications, all the modulators, transmitters, signal processing thing happens. Then NLRC, X. So primarily in LRD, our radars are mostly on L, S, C, and X. And of course, we have done one KU And I have also worked in W band. So that main, our work will be not, so these are very matured components, which have been not only in the radar, it will be in communication, electron or any other RF communication. So this L band to Ku band, almost that transmitters like TR modules, the LNAs, mixers, A2D converters, all things are being mastered. But the question is that, you know, that spectrum is always, there is a scarcity and there is money is involved. And the encroachment of this mobile communications, other like 4G, 3G, they are using most of the S band. So there is a need to explore the other bands. It's not only for military, but civil. So like, people are now expanding this side, actually. Is there going beyond this, like 40 gigahertz, like Ka band, there is a V band, W band, and people are talking about terahertz, which is goes around 500 gigahertz. And different standards are there. That is not, so mostly we use that radar designations, like HF, VHF, UHF. And there is other similar frequency are called in different nomenclature, like EW, international standard, different, but they refer to the same. So main thing that already I explained, so radar is basically consists of, irrespective of the function of the radar or type of radar or platform radar, they basically they do the same thing. So they have transmitters. If there is a monostatic radar, there is a circulators. So transmitter use the pulse time, the pulse, and the pulse goes to the circulator, so the antenna radiates, and the echo comes back in the same antenna receives. But the circulator try to provide a low impedance path to the receivers, and the echo is received for the collect receiver, and all the receivers now, they mix of analog and digital, but nowadays digitals are also come climbing up. So RFs are reducing and there is a display. So this is the main thing all the radar does. So it's more in a details way what a radar does. Basically it illuminates, basically transmitter called illuminators. So you illuminate the electromagnetic energy to the targets, and to illuminates, it requires the waveform, basically the modulators, which does the generation of the modulations, which provide the waveform has a specific property to estimate the target parameter, namely range, azimuth, Doppler, etc. And these echoes received by the collectors is nothing but the receive antenna receivers, and more precisely in signal possible to beam forming, that we form so many beams, and some, and there is a signal extraction. It is basically signal processing, basically to extract the targets from the unknown signal, like your clutters, reflection coming from land, vegetations, clouds, or the unwanted thing. Then you have to take a decision. And the signal processor does that. You have to decide if the target they are not with having a lot of very high probability detection and reducing the false alarm. The data processor is nothing but tracking. So you have to, from this basic detections, you have to find out the target, other parameters like headings, and that is speed, and it is maneuverability, and all these track histories. And this information finally, that became information, nowadays it will go to the higher echelons, command and control for military context, and for civilian application like weather radar, traffic control radar, to their respective higher echelons to take decisions and use the radar output. So mainly the threats of the radars are particular targets. So radar design is almost similar, but the variation takes place not only for the sake of radar, but depending on the target, what type of target you are trying to, that is your threats. So in military, always regular threats, but target threats are synonyms. So we have a threats from lands, we have a vehicle, means the target could be a land or building. Some cases we want to image. So for synthetic aperture radar, all buildings are threats. And for battlefield surveillance radar, main vehicle, these are the surface-based targets. And there is a aerial targets, that is helicopters, UAVs, fighter aircrafts, commercial aircrafts, cells and rockets, missiles, and others, projectiles. And the missile could be surface to air, air to surface, and surface to surface. Other threats, targets are like satellites, could be man-made or natural. Then this radar could be put onto a platform like the ship-based radars, vehicle-based radars, aerial radar, and space-borne radars. So radar targets are already told, like sea surface target, like ships, boats, dinghies, and periscopes. This already I am working coastal surveillance radars. These are the main targets. Then that is the targets nowadays, like radars are being used for exploring underground as well, ground penetrating radar, IDs, unexplored exposed mines, and ground like land and ground moving vehicles, the aircraft, helicopter, already told, cruise missiles, ballistic missiles, satellite, etc. already told. But radar has to not work in a free space. All the time, the radar signal has to compete or getting already impeded by these mediums, and the mediums are complex. Radar signal has to propagate in sea surface. It has to propagate in soil, foliage, walls, air, very adverse weathers, even if exo-atmospheric things. And not only radar signals will get a signals, radar will get its own signal. It will be interfered by the intentional jammings, by the adversaries, by enemies. And it will be sometimes unintentionals coming from radiation or other things. So this is, I gave the background. Since my talk is more on millimetry, I have a time, I'll go quickly over to the millimetric wave. So this millimetric wave radars, I'll just talk about the why this millimetric radar is getting popular and what are the frequency bands suitable for the millimeters, and what are the already existing chips and electronics components are available to build a millimetric radar, and what are the reason how people choose it. And there is a different applications I'll touch upon broadly, but I have a specific talk on both military as well as automotive applications. A few slides are there. That's all. Then I personally work in a practical radar we delivered, we used. So I'll try to share with you and this components and all that. Why this millimeter radar is getting popular? So this is also called EHF, extra high frequency, 300 gigahertz, 300 megahertz. These are called millimeter bands. The main reason is that all you know that there is called atmospheric windows. When the electromagnetic waves try to propagate, the losses depend on the water contents and the other atmospheric particles. And the electromagnetic waves try to give you different losses and different bands. So that's called windows, which is being studied extensively by the researchers and documented. So people found that the entire band is not suitable because there is always, due to the nature of the wavelength and propagation conditions, so you'll find there is a different windows in mm wave itself. So one is around 24 gigahertz. Some people call it is a millimeter wave, but that is a, that's not. Then there is a around 38, that is Ka band. Then before that, there is a around 60, 66. Then there is a 77 to 81. What's currently almost 90% of the millimeter radar, that one. And what military in UA, particularly US, we also work in India, the 94 gigahertz. So these are the four bands are four frequency are there. The main advantage of this millimeter radar, which is very unique, that is basically high resolutions, which is usually not possible or very difficult to do in a microwave radars, particularly suitable for imaging. And very compact systems, when you want to use like seeker or some other smart ammunition or you want to put a radar. So the millimeter with the solutions, compact systems. Another thing is that it's provided with a high Doppler, which you try to measure the micro motions, any vibrations, micro motions or gestures, that will talk details. And in the similar accuracy, the radar size is quite small. Other elements are because a lot of equipments are coming in millimeter as well and provide high gain. And all of us know that why radar still survived compared to other sensors like competition from camera, sonar, things like lasers. The reason is the radar works fairly well in spite of fog, smoke, and dust, and it is most of the time better than infrared like IR and day night camera. So these applications are so many for millimeters: the interspace communication, collision avoidance, short-range fire control radars, closing weapon, and imaging applications. The main reason is compared to the disadvantage of this millimeter radar is basically, you know, all of us know, when you go in higher frequency, there is a losses. The losses are increased drastically when you go. So usually millimeter radars used for short range applications. So people have divided, but people are talking more than that. like they call terahertz and nothing, I'll not talk. This is the way what classification is, what I'm 30 to 300 megahertz. There is 100 to 1000, there is a 300 to 3000 gigahertz. So I think that these are the beyond my scope I talk. They call terahertz frequency. I'll talk only the first one, 300 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. So this is already a talk. I think I don't have to spend time on this. This is the way bands. So one thing that applications are humongous, and it is extensively used in military, particularly 94 gigahertz for safety purpose avionics, particularly for in the last patch when the crash landing and all the private is used in civil avions. And navigational alerts in accidents. So there are so many. So this I'll skip it. So I'll just tell you what some physics behind it. The propagation impedance is a major concern for the radar designers. Always we know that when we lower the frequency, the propagation has a major effect for decide the maximum range of the radar. It decides the detection, ranging, tracking function of millimeter radars. Propagation includes atmospheric absorption, attenuation due to rainfall, snow and fog. Rain and wet snow produce the most serious attenuation effect on military radars. Dry snow, cloud, fog has a much lesser effect. So these are the studies conducted basically to design the antennas and the power amplifier particularly. And these are already I spoke for all of us. This is the windows, which has been studied very extensively up to low 10 gigahertz to up to that infrared region. So you can see that the windows are available. So I told already people are using. And this why this millimeter radar has, from the literature, what we found, mainly that all the components and ICs are being funded hugely by research, all this automotive company. These are basically car. You may think either why they are doing, because almost all the modern cars are having radars, and they are not one radar. There are 8 radars are available in one vehicle. So these are the things happen in reverse way. Usually the military do research and civil try to use it, but particularly this millimeter radar is extensive research has happened in civil, particularly all this company Hughes, Alpha, Siemens, Telefunken, Dalmier, Benz, Philips and Marconi from this ocean side, particularly Germany and US, and others is Japanese counterpart, Toyota. They are also very active and aggressive in millimeter wave program. So these are just from literature what they use. They have been using, but much more is happening now. So they use for semi-automatic headway control using millimeter radar. These are companies, they have their own product, GM, Toyota, Dalmier, Benz. Traffic management by General Motors, all the things, and collision warnings. All the companies, they use this radar, this thing. But what you have to study, to make a radar, we require the, I told you already that modulators, transmitters, antennas, receiver, mixer, these are the components required. So the question is whether this type of things is viable or not. But you can see the visual control oscillators, which is usually used in mostly the GaN diode based driver amplifier, power amplifier, doublers, mixers, switches, and high electron mobility transmitter amplifiers already available. And these are the available different bands. 94 gives the impressive performance clarity, noise figure, also components are available. And this already we have used, and this is also indigenously, the DRDO did a lot of research there. And this FM radar is very popular in millimeter radars. So this gallium arsenide, aluminum gallium arsenide or gallium arsenide based millimeter wave processing established to realize all these components in millimeter waves. Primarily that now people are focusing more on 70 gigahertz. Apart from this millimeter wave substrate, nowadays I'll talk you, people are also able to implement entire radar on a BiCMOS technology by Texas Instruments only. That is the main reasons this millimeter radar has now come to civil. I'll discuss further in this. mainly that all of us, we know that higher the frequency, we'll be able to get the smaller antenna, but with having high accuracy, the angular resolution increases. Another thing is the bandwidth. So if you want to get a resolutions, so normal radars, we get in order of meters, like 30 meters or maybe 10 meters or 20 meters. But the amount, the resolution talked in millimeter radar in terms of centimeters, even people are talking about micrometers resolutions. So this is only possible if you go for higher bandwidth, and the bandwidth is not in terms of megahertz, in terms of gigahertz. So the radar, what already I was working, that was on 400 megahertz, and now though I'm working on radar, it is around 4 gigahertz. Range resolutions, increased optical sensitivity in millimeter wavelength, increased to human interface, smaller, lighter components, advantage. So this is the some sort of typical calculation I did. You can see that if you are operating, we are designing antenna of 4 inch. So the beam width is what you will get. The angular accuracy, you'll get angular resolution, you'll get 9.2 degree. But if you try to operate directly at 94 gigahertz, it'll be around 2 degree without changing the size of the antenna. So same antenna, you will get a almost one tenth of size accuracy. So these are the benefits of antenna size in millimeter radar. And then another powerful thing is called Doppler frequency. You can see that you just take the 10 gigahertz, I am getting a one Doppler, suppose 1.7 kilohertz. One person is moving, suppose a speed of some 20 kilometers per hour. But the same thing, if I see in 100 gigahertz, my Doppler will become 10 times. That is, it became 17 kilohertz. So very subtle movements, particularly ultra low Doppler for detecting very micro motions like crawling hands or some other things like heartbeats, can be measured by micro radar, so millimeter radar. So millimeter radar are also becoming popular for other civilian applications, for medical as well, basically for vital signal measurements. So this is already I spoke about this. So the main conclusion is that it provides high resolution in angle and very, very Doppler sensitivity, extremely high in millimeter waves, high accuracy, interference can reduce, is extremely work in multipath clutters, and the major thing is the large bandwidth, and it works in adverse weathers. So these are typical, we can see that always you try to design a radar, you have to study the, what is the signature of the RF signature of the target. So this is the typical main man who is walking 1 meter squares, car and 10 square meters, the van vehicles, debris on the road. These I'm talking about the automotive perspective. So you can see the road surface also reflects. This gives a radar cross section in the order of 10 to 4 meters square, meter by square. That is called reflectivity coefficients. So this is the way actually one radar, what being already used for this thing, we've seen it, this one, and we basically replace this radar by indigenous developed. So I just put you, this is one of the radar from UK. This is used in perimeter surveillance, all this, even for vehicles, autonomous navigation, etc. So this is a radar, sees everything, security radar, looks for movement of the people, and this range is around 800 meters, and it is resolution 25 centimeters. It will classify the movement of people in the vehicle. The signal processor filter out the false alarm from the non-human movements like trees, birds, etc. And the flexibility to mount on the radar at the ground level, higher up, and it can co-mount to the camera as well. This is from Naptec. They can retrieve the radar surveillance. You can see that apart from radars, the millimeter radar, particularly 77 gigahertz, used for this very small local area networks like office area network, you can say, and telecommunication black holes, consumer electronics, and last mile in the communication, basically we call a local loop communication, means millimeter in local loop. And these are the others applications like 38, 60, 95 gigahertz already being used, but combat systems, military, phased radar, and other things. So these are some of the examples I'll give you. These are the one of the basic typical axioms of millimeter radar for basically movement of vehicle inside a tunnel. The due to the vehicle can stop if the radar sends the debris in the night times, particularly this thing. So this is the thing I gave you the background. So now we'll go to the what work on some of the case study what we work. Basically, there is a requirement for us. This advantage I'll tell you, to design a radar basically for autonomous ground vehicles. So this is the radar what I told you, the NAVTIC from UK, and you can see this is used in vehicles, and this is basically used sometimes with the help of other camera and IR sensors to driverless vehicle, basically for military to neutralize any some sort of, you can see like nuclear explosions or some other hazardous thing where people cannot drive the vehicle directly. So these vehicles are used, but the main thing, the vehicle has to be driven unmanned, so it requires the very high accuracy sensor. This radar was done. So this main objective for us was to replace this radar because this radar was not giving. So we work. This name of the objective of the project was the development millimeter collision avoidance sensor for unmanned ground vehicle to provide range bearing in terms of the obstacle in the vehicle path. So this is a spec, and this radar was capable of detecting human being, rocks, metallic objects, all type of vehicle in front of the things. It all with us. It was having a 60 degree view and 100 meters spec. And before going to that, I just want to tell you that the pulse radar what I discuss, so they are very used only for military, and they have a lot of disadvantages to become a short range radars. The short range radar, I'm telling 100 meter, 200 meter at maximum range of the radar. Minimum range is maybe 1 meter, 2 meters. This we usually perform through FMCW. So all of you know this FMCW is nothing but it is a chirp signal, which is we try to modulate the signal from lower frequency to higher frequency entire bandwidth delta F, and over the 2 sweep periods, and the echo comes, and the echo signals are bitted with the transmit signal directly, and the difference between the echo signals and the transmit signal, the bit frequency is that is AB here, it is directly proportional to the range. So in case of pulse radar, we'll measure the delay directly. But in case of FMCW radar, we try to measure the frequency difference, that is called bit frequency AB, which is indirectly proportional to the things I'll just tell you. This is a much more elaborate mathematical way I'm telling. These are used in all millimeter radars. So you can see this FMCW and millimeter radar is synonym. Of course, people are trying for pulse radar and other type of modulations, but almost 90% of the millimeter radar are FMCW. So here you can see that FB is directly proportional R, and because your FM, which is nothing but that equation, FM is equal to 1 by 2 into sweep, and delta F is the bandwidth of signals, and this order of the bandwidth of millimeter radar is more than all means 500 megahertz, etc., which provide a centimeter resolutions, and other things are constant. So instead of measuring the R, we measure the FB, and mostly we take a Fourier transforms after reading, and the Fourier transform directly give the frequency, and the frequency in calibrated to the measure the range. So in typical, not only that, now this is for static target, but one problem is like this FMCW radars. So target, not only you have to detect the stationary target, you have to do the moving target. So when you have a moving target, so when you receive the echoes and that bit frequency I told you to measure the range, it will not only be range, it will be also get modulated by the Doppler. So there are techniques are there. We use a up chirp and down chirp techniques. So when you try to modulate the signal in upward direction, so the echo will be like proportional to the difference between range frequency and Doppler frequency. If your RAM, if your signal modulation is from high to low, then it's opposite. So by simply averaging these two equations, we can find out the FR and FD. FR is nothing but the range. It means directly it measure the range, and FD measure the velocity. That is called Doppler. These are typical architectures almost all the millimeter radar do, but only depend on the components. Some people do the classical way earlier, component based. So you have antenna separate, and there is a RF front end that includes the circulators. There is a voltage control oscillators which generate directly the millimeter waves. There is Doppler mixers and bandpass filters. And remaining things is like signal processor units, which is basically data acquisitions, FFT and signal processing and decisions, particularly thresholding, etc., and to provide the position, range, bearing of the obstacle and control display. This is typical of a collision avoidance radar, particularly for automotive. And these are DAS I'm just showing. This is the way it works. You can see that in this type of DAS, antennas are not a classical because antenna is so small. Instead of rotating the antenna, you can put a mirrors because the millimeter wave properties are sometimes a little bit different from conventional microwave. It will closest to light. So instead of rotating the antenna, to reduce the cost, we rotate the plate itself. The plate also rotated the beams. So these are the very old neutral radar. Nowadays, these radars being replaced by phased radar and chip-based radars. I'll talk later. These are, we did in 10 years back. So this radar became older now. So these are the things that time it was a state of the art. We work, we put in our vehicle for autonomous navigation. This is our work. But now, this is the this thing. Now I'll talk about the what is the like what I can see that research or some sort of components which actually drive the miniaturization of this millimeter radars. So millimeter radar, as already told, is a generic. It is nothing different from conventional radar, except that components are different. So you can see that how people, if you see now, there are tubes are also available. So I'm talking about transmitter. Transmitter of millimeter wave will be two types. One is whatever we work is like transistor types. They are very low power. They can provide you maybe 100 milliwatt or 200 milliwatt for short range applications. But millimeter radars are particularly Russian origin. They are used for very long range applications. They use even they can generate power of kilowatts, which is very comparable to the microwave radars. So you can see these are typical power amplifiers available. So you can see 80 gigahertz, the silicon germanium transistor bonded, they provide only 310 milliwatts, 60 milliwatt like that. But these are devices available, but I'll go for the tubes you can see here. But if you want to generate a power of kilowatts, so similar to microwaves, you have to use the tubes. Tubes are already there. These are being used by Russian people. Gyratron and other Klystons, all the things, they can generate powers at 94 gigahertz, 2 kilowatts, at 80 gigahertz, around 100 watt like that. These are the very long range radars. But my focus, these are things already available, and all our military radars are there, being already in operationals in 38 gigahertz, 95 gigahertz, etc. The receivers, mostly they use the gallium arsenide substrates, and it is a very special thing. But frankly, I'm speaking, we don't have this type of thing component. This is all the components are imported to make a military radar. And so, apart from these classical receivers, nowadays the MMIV chips are available, front end LNAs, and mixture diodes for limiters up to terahertz frequencies. Company like Qur and Gus Limited, they provide the type of chips. Antennas, yeah, so all kind of antennas, those are available in microwave. People are trying the same configuration in double band. So there is a Hun antennas, and parabolic field is a common one. Other specific antenna, like when people use lenses, like microwave lenses, most of the lenses are used very for short range applications. So you, actually the first one, the prime focus, whatever you use in our product, it's these are the classical things, prime focus, dual reflector, offset feed, and the lens antenna, the dielectric lens, zone dielectric, Lonsberg lens, Hun antennas, all are being used. It's a very old technique, but nowadays people are going to again microstrip kind of things and for telecom, for mobile, automated applications. Other band gap materials are being tried out by different researchers to make the antenna in millimeter frequencies. But this is the genesis. Millimeter radar exists, not only now, it exists. Some literature I saw, it is there in UAS, etc. They have radars in this. So I'll just summarize something. These are some of the 77 gigahertz radar videos which captured from the different traffic. This is the summary of the old radars, what I got from literature. So there is a 40 gigahertz radars from Brazil, and there is a 40 gigahertz, 20 to 40 gigahertz Russian radars, SNARS for this, again Russian, that is surface to air missile radars, cross suit missile fire control radar 20 to 40 gigahertz, weather navigation radar 20 to 40 gigahertz, airborne millimetric surveillance source rescue landing radar 100 gigahertz, France is another radars, ELM 221 Israeli multifunction search track guidance radars, gunnery flycatcher Mark II Netherlands, it is a, again Cavan radars. So this is the trajectory, so that this technology was there, but mostly they use tubes and on classical technology, but and this is again the advancement in transistors and other thing. So you have a other kind of what I discussed, the W800 radar, what we replaced with our own indigenous systems. This is a double band, but it is based on transistor, not on tubes. This is a short range radars, and but these are the just I want to show you that millimeter radar is not a new technology. It is there, but it was using for military. It was being used for military, but based on the very specific research by the country, and they were to develop that thing. It was mostly not popular like micro radar, but they were exist, and in some cases they were giving a lot of benefits. So I'll not discuss much on this. So these are the things I want to see you, like that. There is a Hellfire radars, 94 gigahertz from US. I use an Apache helicopter using this one for the surveillance and target identification. Also, there is IFF also available in millimeter, if I can say. So this top, I'll just summarize these things. Now, what are the things is happening currently and future? So this radar technology is rapidly going from millimeter to sub-millimeter and terahertz. The main reason is it is also provide the same benefits of the coherent integration, all the thing of the microwave radars, the polarization bandwidth, all the thing, whatever being achieved in microwave, the same thing being achieved in millimeter wave. So it is able to get benefit of the same, most of the things already matured in microwaves. And mainly due to the accuracy and other the target classifications, recognitions are becoming much more accurate, and the radar is became very close to camera now, a lot of cases, particularly for non-corbit target identifications. And millimeter also are much more superior in terms of its electronic protections, basically electronic countermeasures, basically to protect the radar from jamming and other EW things, and it is becoming interoperable. So the future is very bright for military radars, and of course that due to this all advent of artificial intelligence, this millimeter radars are becoming much more popular. So I'll leave this one slide, so I'll go to the conclusion. So main thing is what is the millimeter radar at 94 gigahertz, particularly enhanced the capability radars, and they are being used for smart ammunitions like such as radio frequency fuse for missile, as well as for missile seeker. And 94 gigahertz also used in automotive robotics and handle devices, medical perilous surveillance. I think for our side, the component wise, we have not done. Of course, we have done some radar by particularly that, but mostly it is done in abroad. But the part two, I'll tell you the what is the current trend is happening. Maybe 2009 or 10 onwards, there is a huge shift in this millimeter radar for civil applications. So it is entirely different from that one. That one mostly on classical radar was being tried at millimeter frequency, mostly for long range for tubes and for this thing. That is all component based, discrete kind of things, similar radar. But now it is coming as a new trend because of all this functionality now put in a chips. So this is one of the slides I got from TI, which is providing a solution, entire solution for car radars. So this is basically a front facing radar. There is a long range radar, they call it. Here long range means 100-200 meters. It's not like the classical long range radars. And there is a medium range, maybe 150 meters. Short range, maybe less than 50 meters. So this primarily the front one is for adaptive cruise control, autonomous emergency braking, and the corner radars are used for short range radar, that is for blind spot detection, lane cross assistance, LCA, and front rear cross traffic alerts. So now, and there is a newer applications are by parking, 360 surrounding protection, body and chassis and in-cabin applications. Apart from this, automotives, the millimeter radars, ICs, chip-based radars are used for fluid level sensing, solid volume identification, traffic monitoring and infrastructure systems, robotics, and many others. So, and this is basically the chips are available, what I found. You can surprise that it is not based on the gallium arsenide, not that, it is based on CMOS. That's why these chips are early 20,000, 40,000. It is not a chip, it is a radar itself. So I'll give you further when you go through, you can see. This is the thing only I'm telling, it is more interesting for academic people, for students who want to do research or contribute to the radar. And there is a chips are available which can operate 77 to 70 gigahertz. And mostly it is used for vehicular in many countries, including I think in India. Initially it was 24 gigahertz, is the ISM band, but the radars are being, companies are now shifting from 24 gigahertz to 77. Our 27 gigahertz was giving the same thing they're getting in 77, but they're getting much more benefits. So you can see that that is the way the bands are being allocated internationally. So for industrial and fluid level sensing, the frequency band from 75 to 85 total band is available. For short range, usually they use 77 to 81. For long range, particularly cruise control and driver assistant, that is around 77 to 76. These are already, these are very popular chips are available from TI. I'll go details about the chips. So this is more in a very elaborate way. And I got from them. So you can see that one radar is having, one car is having how many radars? So there is 8 radars are there. So the front, they call adaptive cruise controls, that is a long range radars. And you can see that stop and go and cross traffic control, there is white color coverage, that is by the medium range radars. And this is the line assistant, change assistance and blind spot detection. And there is a for parking and pre-crash thing, there is a short range radars. The range you can see, which is totally unusual for radar engineers, the range are called max ranges, 100 meters, and the accuracy of the distance you see in terms of centimeters or much more than that. So it will be 10 centimeter accuracy, and some cases required in terms of millimeters. So the short range radars are very wide band, and their accuracy is missing, but the ranges are less. You require maybe 30 meters up to or less than 30 meters. Sometimes the minimum range required is some 15 centimeters. And long range radars are 600 megahertz bandwidth, that is 0.6 gigahertz, and range is 10 to 250 meters, and the accuracy requires is 0.1 meters, maybe 10 centimeters. Medium range radars like this. So long range radars used for automatic cruise controls, and medium range radars used for cross traffic alerts and lane change assistance, stop and go, and the blind spot detection. Short range radar mostly for parking and pre-crash applications, mostly for whatever your normal radar, you're using sonar. These radars are replacing the sonar. So this is the same thing from TI. So people are using like single chip radars after solutions. And why that not only it is having the radar in that, it is having DSP chips, total memory and DSP chips inside from TI. So it will be single chip, sometimes dual chips, depending on the applications. So I think there is 3 transmitter, 4 receiver, one combination is there. So many combinations. So there is this is for detection radar. There is imaging radars are coming. Those are using the same as a SAR principle. Like a camera, they can take a photograph kind of thing. Almost all stationary object will come, basically for collision evidences. Very high accuracy, 1 degree accuracies. And short range radar for packing. These are the chips I'm talking, what I'm telling. There is AWR1243. It is not a chip, it's a radar itself. It's a 4 receive, 3 transmitter, I told you. And it is having a SPI interface. I think it is having some sort of signal pausing inside. And some cases you can take that, and this is not signal pausing. This is another chip, that is 1642, AWR1442. This is having crypto, all the thing, memories. There is a DSP chips, particularly does FFTs. And these are a little costlier than that, but it is entire radar is available from TI. Another is 1843. I think this is for 3D actually. Here the it does some. It is similar to that chips, but it I think it does some imaging applications. So this is the one architecture I tell you. Whatever radar block diagram I told you, classical radar you can so big. The entire thing is put in a chip, which size is how much you can say that 2 centimeter or 1.5 centimeter or 1.5 chip. So 1.5 inch chip having two transmitter means two radars, and they are independent waveforms, everything. And there is a four receiver means four receiver. So in fact, it is 2 into 4 is means around 8 radars you can see being put in a single chip. And it is not only having radar, it is having all these power supplies, which was in huge in normal radar, and it is having the other things like the control, all the thing, and that the red processor in the signal processor, which is having everything. FFTs, which is primarily a signal processing function, does in radar, and it is a memory you can store, and there is a microcontrollers, like something you can say, it can does a lot of controls, it can provide interface controls. And it is a different output. It could be a CAN-based thing, that is a automotive serial links, or you can have Ethernet. So many things there, because this chip is a little older, this block diagram, but new things are much more there. So these are just some of the things from internet. I got it. You will get the where the trend is going. So initially, if you see that they started with a bigger chips with some sort of peripherals, and you can see this is the project by Infineon for Google. Basically for gestures, for Google, for gestures is good. Gesture Apollo, I don't know. So they started with all the chips and connected. After research and over the years, they found, you can see the last is a chip. So entire this things has been put inside a single chip. And these radars, basically FM through radar, is used for gestures detection. So this is a very successful product and being used by Google. And this is from Infineon, not from TI. And this is again TI portfolios, I'm telling. So they have a different radar now, and these are already available and being used by all market, and it is being collected by a lot of research agencies, or particular universities, they're having these type of chips. So one is imaging, that is, I think, four chips, each chip having three transmitter, four receiver. So there, I think 48 radars are there in one single chip. So you can have a lot of beams. You can see there is a multiple beams, really like a very massive MIMO kind of things. We have a things, and these chips are and there is a medium range, there is a two chips you can configure, and the long range radars where the single chip is usually used, and short range single chips, and there is so many combination configuration they're providing depending on the application. And not only the chips are used for radar, it can use for communication as well. They have a communication chip as well. So these are the summarized, these are the modern applications, primarily for civil. So obstacle detection sensor, the car door openers, park assistant, suspension control, detection of ice weather on the road, we use. Sometimes the radars being used to occupant, I told you that the child left behind, intrusion detections, your theft and all thing. Occupant classifier means you can see how many people are there by the radar itself remotely, that you can transmit it. And air guard deployment, driver vital sign monitoring. I told you the medical application, what I told. These radars can very precisely measure the heart rate without touching the person, and is sleeping or not, or can be radar can find out. So this is one of the applications being tried out and being used, I think, already. Then there is a kick and open tailgate, HMI screen change, knob control, and pan and open thing. See, all these applications are being, there's a future. So a lot of research are required, because those looks very rosy, but it requires a lot of research. This is one of the things I got from that that 5G, whatever you're talking. So there is a shift actually in the communications. So what are they telling you? There is a data rate is extremely high in 5G. It cannot handle this Wi-Fi and all the whatever is in our house. It cannot handle 5G. So this Wi-Fi will directly now shifted to from 5.9 gigahertz, which is the ISM bands, C-band things, has been directly going to millimeter waves. So in 77 gigahertz, you'll direct 20 is getting that Gbps per data is much easier. So the low rate Wi-Fi will be replaced by millimeter wave Wi-Fi. These are some typical 5G cellular things I got from things, and proposed existing millimeter spectrum for mobile cellular applications. So the bandwidth is here, it's still 3 gigahertz, which is basically narrow band in case of millimeter radar. So you have like a digital pipe, which is microwave, millimeter wave pipe actually. You can send whatever you call like video streaming, everything for short distance. It's much, is only viable due to the millimeter wave technology. So already I told you, because due to this millimeter wave ICs and the 5G, there is a lot of fusing taking place between radar and communications. So people are now talking and already tried out the single chip will have a radar, which can not only do the detection, the same waveform can be used for communicating between the vehicles. Not only communicating, they will provide the other sensor data like lidars, videos, camera data can be used by the chips. So they call JRC. And this is, I was thinking it is a more research, but now a lot of platforms and test beds are available and this is being used. So this is very close to that, what I call it as a, the Internet of Things or sensor network we're talking. So radar is playing a major role, particularly millimeter sensors, because you try to not only sense, but it can communicate in real time. Then, but the reason is why it's becoming popular, because that short range, you can communicate that instantaneous data with high volume that includes video, multimedia, and other things. So that is the main thing. I'll not do, because this is not, it may not be interest for you. So now I'll tell you why this, there is a new trend is coming for this IoT kind of thing. I did hear some literature. So the Internet of Things, what is happening, we might have seen all this, why radar also coming to that. The temperature sensors, weather sensors, other sensors are there, pressure sensors, they are miniaturized and people are putting this Ethernet protocol and they are transmitting wirelessly and we are having. But you saw the one simple car having 4-8 radars. And since the radars have become so cheap, so people are putting radars in drones and multiple drones, and they are being used for collision avoidance and whatever are being used for military radar, same function like altimeters, terrain avoidances. And I told you these radars are being used very extensively, successfully demonstrated for medical application, basically heart rate monitoring, vital signal monitoring. So this is became a main reasons the radars are becoming is one of the major sensor in IoT, particularly sensor network. So the name is again call I saw in the internet, they call is IOR, Internet of Radar. So one typical visualization of application of radar, not the classical radar, in a very complex way. Another thing that one research, basically due to the mainly the optimizations techniques and using modern mathematics, means development in other side, often design, basically people are able to design a single chip rad system, you can say millimeter wave systems, which can use both actually as a radar. Whenever you try to detect the target, when you try to transmit the full radar detection or other things, you can either call radcom. So what is the, there is a comrade, there is a radcom. Radcom is basically is a radar having a communication facility, where the primary is a radar function communication. And there is another concept is called comrade, where the communication is the main thing, but radar function could be auxiliary. So there is a co-execution, co-design. So these are the not theories, these are all test beds, and people are being, it is being already launched in the market. So why I'm telling now, I'll go for a slightly different concept, but it was beneficial for research, which basically this, the problems, whatever being seen in the millimeter wave, though the application looks rosy, but there is huge potential of improvements. So this architecture, what already is being used for long range radars or thing, exactly same architecture can be directly used as a millimeter wave configuration in a very very small compact radar. So this radars are, can be treated like this, derived from MIMO communications. There is a multiple transmitter, multiple receiver, that is called MIMO. If there is a single transmitter or multiple receivers, we call it is multistatic. There is a phase radar. All these concept topologies are range radar. In this academic sense, these are terminology called SIMO, single input, multiple output. There's a multiple input, single output. There's multiple. These are the use in communications as well in radar, mostly for micro frequency. The same topologies are extensively used and being used or researched in millimeter wave. So one thing I just told you, just I think it is a little heterogeneous way I'm presenting, because this is the way one paper I'm presenting. The main thing, the replacement of other sensors like ultrasonics and other electrocardiogram, other sensing, particularly human being particularly medical application being replaced by millimeter radars. So I did a study. So what we found actually that the estimation of the cardiopulmonary activities of human being is much more accurate in radar compared to other sensors. And it is, what do you call, it is like remotely. You don't require to connect the probes to the human bodies, what we do usually any most of the medical devices. So this is one. And the heart rate variability is very accurately being measured by the radar, and it is very successful. Assessment of the vessel electricity using pulse wave velocity information is a good thing. And internal health also. It's not only our external like Doppler measurements, you can also image it the way like done, and you can also see the other things. So radar became a contemporary sensors. And again, the same performance, what I told you, classical radar, the strength of the echo is coming from the reflection. There, the reflection was coming from the object like aircraft or hills. Here, the object where medical radar is, the object is like bones. And the reflection coming from your artilleries, from your others, human organs. And there is a broader vessels, the biological tissues, all the characteristics now being able to studied. And it is not studied, being studied. So the research potential, I'm telling, particularly academic institute, the PhD kind of thing, is a very, very, very active field. So you can take this chip radar from TI, the antennas, the full radar is available, and there is an interface, and they give software also. You can collect the data in the MATLAB, you can directly collect data from field or some other ways, and you can innovate. So this is the one thing I want to share with the college. So can be taken very seriously by your VC department to purchase this radar from TI and try to use, particularly for medical, I'm telling, because this is the thing that we spend a lot of money, because that medical equipment, usually we import from abroad. This is very, very expensive. I think this is the way we can, since I'm from radar community, I urge that it is similar to the cameras happening, image processing was happening maybe 10 years back. So this electromagnetic sensing, particularly for medical application radar, is very intense and is very future. And not only that, a lot of algorithms, including that, machine learning can be directly used and being used now. And the data are easily collected by a student. One day you can collect all kind of possibility of data and you can verify, and that is the thing. So this is the one thing. So this is the way, one typical example of the JRC. So the radar can be used as a standalone monostatic, you can a bistatic, it can use as a network, means if there is a JRC, the communication module is also available, means the communication mode of the radar. So you can communicate. So these are the not a very hypothetical things. These are the real being attempted and being deployed also in Europe and America. So this is the way the, and not only that, but what question is that does the all the problem of the radar is solved? No. So they are getting a lot of mugs. You will get a lot of other issues, which is has to be solved continuously researching. Because apart from the desired signal, all the time radar gets clutters, it radar gets jammed by somebody. Somebody can disrupt the radar function by radiating the same thing. There is a called cyber attack also in the radar networks. A lot of research is being done. So it's a very interesting field for academic. So this is one typical scenario of the IORA telling, that Internet of Radars, with the concept of joint radar and communications. So you can see that in the house, the radar, which is always monitoring the heartbeat of the signal of the person who is moving. And not only it being used for measuring the heartbeat, it can sense the elderly people health, that fall all the things, and somebody then they can instantaneously, it can be communicated to the network. And with the same radar, because the radar can use as a, I told you that millimeter wave pipe, communication pipe. And another, I told you the sensor, the drones are very, you can see the drones are coming, and they try to sometime collide each other. Radars are being used for collision evidences. Not only the same millimeter sensor used to find out the terrain evidence, is exactly similar to the conventional micro radar being used in normal that our fighter aircraft, etc. So in this, I told you already how the 8 radars are there in each vehicles. All the most of the modern vehicle, Mercedes-Benz, Audis, they're having that. Now the radar cost is so low. Now it will come in our classical, our normal household radars by Maruti, Suzuki, and other thing. They are being, and there's a lot of company, they open their office in India. Continental from Germany, they are targeting the entire vehicle of India. So this will have huge potential for job as well as for research. So these are the, some sort of literature thing from net I found for this IOR. Basically, the radar will be fitted into a watch. So it will be very low complex and short range, high data rates, wearable smartwatch, and in home it will be used for tracking people, that available to the people, and fault detection I told already. And that Comrad application, it could be single chip or single monostatic radar, or it will be multiple radars, monostatics. The medical, it will be respiration, heart rates, and it coexistence, other things. And there is a vehicle also driving assistance, not only driving assistance, it will use for parking and other land crossing, or I told you that cross traffic management, drones, and other things. So it is a very thing. So these are some percentage. So earlier sensors were dominating, radar was less, but now radar will try to compete with the cameras, sonar, lasers, and other things. So because due to this, particularly millimeter waves, so that is the. So the these are the things. So radar will be work along with the communications. So that these are the concepts are coming in the community of sensor networks. So radar will provide you one of the sensor and in the thing and join together. So I
Thank you, sir. It's a wonderful session for us, actually. Now, I would like to welcome, give a vote of thanks to Professor Navya, ma'am. Navya, ma'am, over to you, ma'am. Yes, sir. Sir, now we'll wind up the session. Thank you, sir. It's a very wonderful session. It's a very valuable inputs from you beyond this academic, actually. So we'll work on with our students through the medical applications area. It's a new idea for us to work with the students.
Nice. Thank you so much.
Yeah. I would like to welcome Dr. Navya, ma'am, to provide the vote of thanks. Thank you, sir. It's a great pleasure to provide the vote of thanks from East Point College of Engineering, such a wonderful, eminent person to deliver the topic of millimeter radar. It's a new idea, new path for us, actually. I would like to thank our management to provide the opportunity. Navya ma'am?
Ma'am, am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Please provide the vote of thanks, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. I was proceeding with it. On behalf of East Point College of Engineering and Technology, I, Dr. V. Navya, Associate Professor, take this opportunity to propose a vote of thanks to all who have directly and indirectly contributed to this webinar on emerging sensor technology of millimeter wave radar for civil and military applications in association with IEEE Bangalore session and IEEE TEMS. At the outset, we are thankful to our Honorable Founder Chairman of EPGI, Dr. XM Venkatpati sir, for his passion in establishing a world-class institution for upgradation of young minds. I would like to extend my gratitude to Honorable Chairperson Srimati B.L. Ramadevi Venkatpati ma'am, her energetic CEOs, Sri C.V. Pramod Gowda sir, and Sri S.V. Rajiv Gowda sir, for their all-time support to carry out many such programs and events. We are grateful to our respected Secretary Sri Peter Francis sir for his constant support and encouragement. I would like to thank our Honorable Principal Dr. S. Prakash sir for his enthusiastic support. Today's webinar gave a deep insight into the topic and also revealed some interesting topics. I am pretty sure that these precious knowledge will definitely help us in our studies and your future, sir. Thank you, sir. I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to Dr. T.K. Satish, sir, HOD of CS, and Dr. G.S. Yogesh, sir, for HOD of ECE, for all kind words of wisdom that redirected the source of energy within us to organize this webinar. It's my pleasure to thank Dr. Manimozi ma'am, IEEE branch counselor, for her leading supervision and inspiring at every point of time. I would like to thank IEEE Bangalore session and IEEE TEMS for their constant support to carry out various events. I must remark a proficient sense of gratefulness to all our teaching fraternity for their appreciating involvement and willingness. Last but not the least, I appreciate my dear students who have been the strength of this webinar. Also, I would like to thank Professor Pooja Kaware ma'am for her support in this webinar. Once again, I would like to thank each and everyone for being with us. It has remained a pronounced pleasure. Have a great day. Finally, I end up with this inspirational quote: always walk through life as if you have something new to learn, and you will. Thank you, one and all. Sir, thank you, sir. It's a privilege to have you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
We'll hope so. We'll be in touch with some other projects or anything, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sure, sir. So this we'll discuss further.
Sure, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.